Struggling to understand how to collect data from their customers, their relationships across the board, and make decisions that are really relevant to managing that data and that relationship. We've seen a trend where we no longer being transactional and selling just a simple credit card. Bank are moving to the offering of packages, where I'm going to bundle together a mortgage, a credit card or a debit card, some mortgage insurance, and this requires us to work across products and across channels. We've talked a lot about work around channels, but there's a further discussion which is going on around what we need to do on the product side and looking at multiple products. And one of the difficulties that is currently faced by the largest bank, and I was very surprised because I assumed that banks in Australia would already have achieved a greater level of maturity and understanding as to what is the profitability of their individual customer for a given product. But that is not the case. What we really find is that information is in so many silos across the bank that it becomes very, very difficult to aggregate and be able to make something sensible out of that information. So we've got multiple core banking system, multiple products, some of them are very specific to a type of product that we address, multiple channels and customer transact for these channels, data inconsistencies. I think one of the earlier speakers was talking about the holy grail of 360 degrees view, which is rarely achieved in banks today, despite the amount of investment that it actually took in this infrastructure in order to address. And when we talk about transactional, we forget one thing, which is how we could leverage that data that we acquire as part of the process in order to bring more value to the customer. And that's the world of analytics. So these are some of the challenges that we see and we face. Processes on the business side, which is the origination, tend to be disconnected from the analytical side. I'll give you an example. Many years ago when I moved to Central, I was pre-approved by one of the local banks for a credit card. When I applied, I used that credit card application, and I applied. I was then turned down because I had not spent more than 6 months in my job. Effectively, I had just moved to Singapore. And that brings the question as to why the risk data that is used and the eligibility criteria that is used for a risk assessment was not linked to marketing information. Because I can tell you that as a result of this very poor interaction, I have not worked or banked with that organization for the past 12 years. And obviously, moving to a new country, I need a local bank, I need a local checkbook. And as a result, this kind of sold and lost them opportunity. And very often we have not timely interaction. I moved my flat in the UK, I moved some of the money on the point to buy a flat. What happened was that my global bank in the UK called me a month after the fact to find out exactly what was the reason I was making this transfer and whether I would be interested in investing. Well, the answer is by the time I transferred that money and I purchased my flat, the discussion is no longer current. You should have asked me a month ago, not too late. We also see change in behavior. I think many of the speakers here have actually highlighted the fact that we are moving to a world which is becoming digitalized. We use payment in the rooms, I've seen some of you looking at stock prices and doing trading on your mobile phone. Obviously, we change the way we're transacting with our banks, with our brokers, and a lot of it is going to be digital. So we need to be prepared in order to address this requirement. So fundamentally, it's about bringing that information together and being able to analyze that information in order to provide value and context to the discussion we're having with the customer. Being able to understand what is the profitability of a given segment of customer in order to be able to price accordingly. Many years ago, I was traveling to the wonderful country of Pakistan, and I could see that there was a lot of competition between each of the credit card issuers in order to acquire customers. This was a very nascent market with many opportunities to sign new customers because plastic was at the time not very prevalent. Unfortunately, there was a complete disconnect between the finance system and the marketing system. So while banks were successful in acquiring new customers, there was so much liability generated by this contract that one could really question whether these decisions were really profitable. And we've seen in Taiwan, banks losing millions of dollars on their credit card portfolio by basically fighting one another in enlisting customers without looking at the contribution of these given customers to the profitability of their product. So we need to look at the profitability expense side, being able to use this, being targeted in our discussion in order to improve the customer experience and the way we manage our discussion. So one of the first things we need to do is to be able to understand the direct and indirect cost and revenue of a given customer product channel across the bank. So that means Mr. X comes to my bank, and I know that he's, he might not be a premier customer, but he should be treated as such because he's a very, very profitable customer. And that should lead the type of information that I'm going to be able to have with him and the type of discussion that I'm going to be able to have with him. What I would want to understand is the new business. How am I performing versus my target? Which branch is performing best? What's the level of profitability of the activity which is being generated? What's the spread in terms of product? And being able to analyze the contribution of each of the relationship managers. So this is also, funny enough, very rarely implemented in banks to a degree of satisfaction that really gives us the power and insight that will enable us to make this decision. We need to understand what happens in terms of channels. ATM, what's the downtime on each of the ATM? What's the level of non-completion of a transaction? Why was the transaction bought? Is it an elderly person who forgets their PIN, or what is exactly the reason for not going through that transaction? So I need to understand my channels and understand exactly how it's been used by different types of customers. So elderly customers tend to prefer face-to-face interaction with branch, and their customer would rather not visit the branch. So we need to understand the demographic that underpins together with the profitability. And here we're talking about bringing together information that relates to finance, so for example, the credit approval process on the scoring, some information that comes from finance, specifically around the profitability and expense contribution of a given product customer, and some information related to the behavior of that given customer in order to make that picture complete. So channels, obviously, I need to understand my branches, my network, my regions, the contribution of each of these different elements in order for me to pay attention and maybe take some mitigation actions when I realize that trends are degrading in terms of level of satisfaction, for example, with my branch. Now, on the retail side, what we struggle with is the huge amount of data and the huge amount of product. I remember visiting a bank in the Philippines where going through a product assessment, we realized that there were 18 different types of mortgage product that were being offered by the organization, 180 different types of mortgage times. So the issue is that for any significant number, more than 10 applications, we only had 4 of these products that were short to the extent of more than 10 products. So these are the kind of product portfolio and portfolio mix that we need to pay attention to. Because we can come up with many combinations, many nice features for this product, but they don't necessarily make sense. And if we don't have traction, we need to really think of how we can manage them properly. Now on the institutional side, we obviously have more of an aspect in terms of lead management. I mean, the size of the portfolio is obviously much smaller in terms of number of customers, but much higher in terms of number of transactions. But the amount of transactions. So what you really need to look at is breaking down some of these silos. Silos across risk, finance, marketing, and being able to create that true unified picture of the customer. You want to engage and you want to be able to bring that modeling capabilities in terms of decision-making ability. That means understanding what is the probability contribution, but also from the analytic side, what is the upsell probability, what is the wallet share, what is the life cycle. Once you have all the data problems solved, looking at the analytics is actually a simpler problem to solve. Most of the time, when you deal with very clever people, you're dealing with people who are interested in the modeling side, we forget that in any such initiative related to modeling, the biggest problem is never the modeling itself. The biggest problem is always going to be data quality, data consistency, and data synchronization. So we want to ensure that we drive the efficiencies across the organization through this single platform, both on the repository results as well as assessment. And what we want to do then is to optimize this at the level of the branch, people who are in direct contact with customers and are able to influence the workflow. This is my last word, and I hope not to be trampled. As I bid you farewell and wish you a very good one. Thank you very much.